Good morning, Banks Trail.
I'm Walker.
And I'm Abby.
And welcome to the Howl.
So, Walker, have you ordered your yearbook yet?
Yeah, how about you?
I have, but some people haven't.
If you want to order a yearbook, give Ms. Bund your $40 by the deadline of December the 4th.
If I got locked away.
Do you remember that?
Oh, that was so fun.
Oh, yeah, I remember this day.
I don't have any memories.
Well, if you buy your Banks Trail yearbook, you'll always have your memories. It's only $40, and the money is due by December 4th.
Honestly, would you still love me the same? Right about now. If I judge for life, man, would you stay by my side? Or is you gonna say goodbye? Can you tell me right now? If I couldn't buy you the fancy things in life, shawty, would it be alright? Come and show me that you don't. Now tell me, would you really ride for me? Baby, tell me, would you die for me? Would you spend your whole life with me?
Wow, I can't wait for the yearbooks to come out.
Yeah, bruh, it's be so exciting.
What are you saying?
Isn't that how they talk nowadays?
Not at all. You need some tips from Julia Lako on how to talk modern slang.
What's your name?
Coco.
What do you think turnt means?
Like really happy.
Okay. What do you think fleek means?
It's like really perfect.
Okay. What do you think the term what are those means?
It's like you have really ugly shoes and someone is asking you to bring.
Okay, thank you.
I'm Sam.
Okay, tell me what you think turn means.
Get turned.
But tell me what it means.
When you turn up. When you look good.
And what are those?
What are those?
Tell me what you think it means.
My shoes.
Well, what do you think it means when people say that?
You have ugly shoes.
Okay. Thanks.
I am Mr. Godby.
What do you think the word turnt means?
Turnt? How do you spell it? Turnt. Yes.
I'm so turned with
this. Oh, okay. Maybe it means something like excited or looking forward to.
Okay, what do you think the word fleek means?
Fleek? How do you spell that?
F-L-E-E-K. Like
yes. Okay, fleek means this little bug with red spots on it.
Okay.
What are those?
Yeah.
use it in a sentence. it means like, what are those, I guess. I don't, what's up?
Okay.
Where do we look?
Sydney!
Olivia!
Okay, Mikana, what do you think the word turnt means?
I don't know. Partying?
Let's get turned.
Let's just say partying.
Yeah.
On point, like my eyebrows.
Oh, please.
And Olivia,
what are
those?
What are those? It means like your shoes are not that cute. Like, what are those?
Okay, thanks.
Peace.
I am Mr. Edwards. I teach 8th grade social studies.
What do you think the word turnt means?
Turnt. For one to be turnt, I think it means one has a good time. What was that?
Fleek.
I absolutely have no idea, and I think I'm younger, and I understand what... Yeah, use it in a sentence, please. Her shirt is on fleek. It's on point. All right. What are those? Sentence. No sentence? Oh, those are uglier. What the heck's going on with those? Yeah.
Miss Hermanson. Turnt? Like turnt up? Like Giving crazy. Ever since I left the city. Fleek, like on fleek. Like cool. Yes. What are those?
Yeah. You used to call me on my cell phone.
Thanks, Julia. Now I know how to talk with style.
I'm wondering, what's your favorite subject, Walker?
I like science. Why?
Because some of the 8th grade students had to make commercials on waves.
Well, that's all we have for today.
Have a great weekend. Bye!
Hello guys,
motivation.
This is
my one solution is my queen, cause she stays strong.
Here, a yearbook.
Yeah. She is always in my corner, right there when I wanna. All these other girls are tempted.
In my science class, we decided to create wave commercials. And the students had to create a commercial about how a certain wave is used, and they had to explain what it was used for and then try to sell that to someone. So it gave the students practice in how electromagnetic waves are used in the real world, and it also gave them some practice with their persuasive writing skills.
From microwaves to mobile phones, we present microwaves. And here are some facts about microwaves.
So what seems to be the problem?
My leg really hurts, but when I went to Nurse Nato's office, she didn't have any x-ray waves to put in her x-ray.
Let me see what I can help you with.
I wish there was a way that we could actually see.
Well, now you can. Introducing visible light.
Waves are the third most powerful light waves. They can cause damage to your eyes and prevent you from reading your favorite book. But light waves are UV rays are the third most powerful electromagnetic waves.
What is that?
Would y'all like to buy some okay ham for lunch? Hey, little girl. Yeah. Infrared waves make you taller.
Really?
No.
What's wrong? My life is really dull. I wish there was something to brighten it up.
Well, I have just the thing for you. Whoa!
What is it?
This is the beginning to your new bright life.
That's amazing. I've never seen such colors before. Could you explain a little bit more about them?
Sure. The first thing you need to know is that these colors you now see are only a tiny part of the electromagnetic spectrum.
Whoa, really?
That's great. Can an x-ray see a bomb in my suitcase?
What? A bomb! It's in the suitcase!
Hey, this is the Radio Wave Station with...
Oh, man!
Hey, man, we need radio waves to send those sweet jams.
Have you ever wanted to keep yourself warm without a blanket? Have you ever wanted to control a device without trying to get up and walk over to it? Have you ever wanted to communicate with someone else close in range? If you've answered yes to any of these questions, then I have a wave for you. I present unto you the infrared waves.
Some examples. Cheap sunglasses, not polarized, bad. Oakley sunglasses, really expensive, polarized. You see the difference.
Danger, danger. Too much light can cause damage to the retina in your eye.
Visible light is like a triangle.
What?
Cool. You know what? Your radio won't work?
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Radio wave!
What are those?
Wow, I have a patient today. Looks like they broke 36 bones.
Doctor, help me!
What's wrong?
I think I broke my body.
Okay, let's take an x-ray. Yep, it's assured. You've broken your body.
I'm Skylar Hubbard reporting for The Howl.
Well, that's all we have for today.
Have a great weekend. Bye!